Hey there, you have tuned into our weekly podcast called Equity Masters Stock Market Wrap-Up. This is Rini talking to you from Mumbai. With the benchmark indices touching record highs this week, let's look at what is moving the markets. So let's jump right in. Domestically, it seemed like market participants in India's equity markets are really forward-looking. Despite all the depressing news about the economy in the media and a plethora of gloom and doom, the markets were at all-time highs. The Sensex touched the 41,000 mark for the first time ever on Tuesday, and Nifty surpassed the 12,100 mark at a time when prime economic indicators and some high-frequency data are at loggerheads with the market's euphoria. The markets, however, turned flat on Thursday. Market participants were cautious ahead of the important GDP and fiscal numbers that were released by the end of this week. Globally, Asian markets mostly retreated after Donald Trump signed a bill supporting Hong Kong protesters, a move that could potentially infuriate Beijing and complicate the US-China trade talks. Trump's move could heighten tensions between Beijing and Washington, as the two sides had been working toward reaching a trade deal. China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs blasted the law on Thursday, saying that, I quote, such an action has seriously interfered in the Hong Kong's affairs and China's domestic politics, unquote. Markets had reacted positively this week amid hopes for a US-China trade deal. Major US indices posted fresh record highs on Wednesday. European stocks are also at multi-year highs. In another news, foreign money once again made its way into Indian equities. Foreign portfolio investors infused a net of 177 billion rupees into the Indian markets in November so far, amid encouraging domestic and global cues. Data showed that overseas investors pumped in a net sum of 176 billion rupees into equities and 1.8 billion rupees in the debt segment. FPIs were net buyers in the preceding 2 months as well. Note that the rupee had dropped to 72.24 against the US dollar earlier this month, a whisker away from a 9-month low of 72.41 set in September. Selling pressure was seen due to escalating levels of public debt and a credit crunch among NBFCs. Meanwhile, our finance minister ruled out recession in economy. Well, finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman said, the Indian economy may be facing a slowdown, but there's no danger of a recession taking hold. The government will make policy changes as and when required. Every step being taken is in interest of the country, the minister said in her reply to a discussion on the economic situation in the upper house of parliament on Wednesday. She said, and I quote, looking at the economy in discerning view, you see that growth may have come down, but it is not recession yet. It won't be recession ever, unquote. Now moving on to the news from the IPO space. The IPO of Kerala-based CSB Bank, which opened on Friday last week, was fully subscribed on day one itself, with strong interest seen from retail investors. It will be interesting to watch how this IPO opens on the listing day. Speaking of IPOs, this one IPO has been the hot topic in the world over. I am talking about the Saudi Aramco IPO. Well, there's a lot going on this front. Saudi Aramco's much heralded and often delayed initial public offering is going ahead, although in a scaled down version of the original plan by Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. There will be no grand opening on the London or New York stock exchanges. The sale is restricted to the Saudi bourse and won't even be marketed to most international money managers. Investors will be able to purchase just 1.5% of the world's most profitable company, about half what was previously considered. Even so, the share sale in early December will come close to or even surpass the record for the biggest IPO in history. So what does all that mean for crude oil investors and traders? And why is it important? Well, at a time when Saudis are not sharing many details with their Wall Street investment bankers, Vijay Bambani in his latest video raises a few questions that the mainstream media is not covering and not even crude oil traders are asking. Well, I insist you tune into that video available in the video section of the Equity Master website. Also, if you want to grab a pie of the big money-making opportunities beyond stocks, I would strongly recommend you log on to Fast Profit Dailies on the website. We gotta wrap it here. Do come back next week for our market analysis and updates. Remember, it's equitymaster.com. Now, before I sign off, I would like to know whether you like our podcasts. We would love your feedback. Just visit equitymaster.com and drop us a line. We look forward to hearing from you. Have a profitable week ahead. Thank you.